And over the last 9 months, the words of that song have become real to me. When I was a little bit more, I didn't understand what it was that my mother was teaching me, the song that she was sharing with me and instructing me to learn and what to sing. But as I began to grow older and as life begins to hit you with that tumultuous and tragic situations, sometimes what you've learned as a child will become life to you as an adult. But there was one line of that song, also one line of the song that jumped out at me immediately. And it says that life is sealed with swift transition. That we're going to go through things in life. Sometimes we're going to be hit with situations and ordeals and your circumstances that are going to be out of our control. Stuff that we're not going to be able to fix and we'll put back together again. Dilemmas and your circumstances that are going to hit you with the purpose of causing you to buckle and making you believe that God has literally forsaken and forgotten you. Me, I'm talking to everybody, but I know that I'm talking to somebody that has been through some things. That have gone through some things that it looked like you did not understand why it hit you, because you did not sow it, so you did not expect to reap it. I'm not talking to everybody, but I'm talking to somebody that's been through some hell this year. Some stuff that has been raising up in your life, and you can't understand it. It makes no sense. It doesn't seem like it's even going to end. And it seems like the more you make 2 steps forward, you go 8 steps backward. It seems like the more you try to fight through it, the more you try to travail through it, the more difficult the circumstances seem to get. But I found out something, beloved. I found out that even though I'm in situations that are uncomfortable, I recognize and I realize that this is simply the attack plan of the enemy. His mindset and or his goal is to get you as a believer to fool by any means necessary. The only reason why the enemy is trying to get you to fool by any means necessary is simply because somehow, some way, he has peeked into your future and sees what God's about to let you into. And we understand is that if you just persevere, if you stay strong, if you ain't got to run fast, you ain't got to run fast, you ain't got to run fast, all you got to do is just endure. You recognize it, but you're going to walk into something that is going to blow your mind. However, he's trying to get you to quit. He's trying to get you to stumble. He's trying to get you to fold. And that's why he's hitting you with everything at the kitchen sink. Because it is his mindset that if he can hit you with everything that he has, that you will become despondent and dismayed and decide, rather than going forward, I'd rather stay here and be comfortable in this man. Because it seems like the more I go forward, the more painful it begins to become. I ain't talking to everybody, but I know I'm talking to somebody that understands. And it seems like the more you move forward, the more difficult it begins to become. And can I tell you why it is? It's because God is trying to build tenacity and strength in you. He's trying to get you to understand that if he be for you, he is more than the world against you. And that this ain't the time or the place for you to be giving up, because there's some stuff that's ahead of you that's going to blow. And he's sitting right here to tell you that if you just keep moving forward, that the rest of your days are going to be the best of your days. Take somebody, look in the face and tell them the rest of my days. I'm going to be the best of my days. Well, I know it don't look like it right now, because you're walking by what you see. But I stop right here to tell you that if you can just get to that next level,
Thank you.